come on. Their charitable defense lately. They own the worst goals against average in the Western Conference. He's very happy with their attack, but not the D.
Speaking of attack, Brendan Morrow is going at center with Steve Bégin, who comes and cranks Morrow down to the ice. Pardon me, not Morrow.
It's been eons since I've seen the pant grab and takedown from a player. Bégin, who sacrilegiously wears number 25 in Calgary.
Yes.
Joe Noondike's old number. He and Garbutt, right from that draw, get after it. Little jostle, you want to go? Sure, let's go. Bejan's the roadie for them. He's dressed every road game. He's sat for five of their home games. And he's in for this type of stuff. Not just fighting, but to give him a little weight and some grit.
Five each for fighting does not affect the manpower advantage on the ice. Roman Horak, who was not in last week, is here tonight. And Jackman trying to rub sticks with Jamie Benn. Fiddler trying to get away from Horak. Daly following it up. Threw it to the line. And Butler. Lenkros shot it. Bachman kicks it out.
Well, speaking of Ryan Garbutt, I thought he had a major impact on that road trip. Scored a dazzling individual effort goal in Edmonton in the third period and changed the path of Burrow's first, but really was the first guy that changed the momentum in the hockey game when he fought his old college buddy, Paul Patty. That started three fights in a row. All three guys on the line, Fiddler and Nystrom after Garbutt. The hit on Burrows really ignited things, though, for Dallas, and then those scraps.
TJ Brody handing it off. Tang